somebody. You know that I could use somebody, someone like you.
Basically, when you get into that relationship and you've been there for a while, and it's you try what you can within your capacity, and it's time to end the relationship. But give you a story. A friend of mine at the moment, currently, he's going through a breakup, but he finds it so hard to break up with his woman, and it's always in that interaction, and it does have an effect, obviously, with his life. What keeps that bond there still, and not to let go? Is there something else?
Well, it could be two things. I mean, it can be many things. Uh-huh. It can be love, but it can also be fear, economy, comfort,
convenience,
security, convenience, all the, you know,
timing.
It can be all those really, you know, to me, they're base reasons to be in a relationship. They're sort of like, they're not the reason to be in a relationship. They are like, they're sort of like, limited, you know, in my perception. And what keeps him in that? I don't know. I need to speak to the guy, you know, but I really need to see exactly what's going for him. But it does bring up that essence. Why are we in relationship? You know, why can't he just say, hey, you know, like, this isn't working for me, and leave? What's keeping him there?
Yeah, there must be some sort of,
you know, is it hope, or is it just because he's like afraid of stepping out on his own? You know, does he still need his mother? You know, is he an initiated man who's doesn't need mum anymore, or is he seeing his woman through the lens or perception of mother, you know, unconsciously, and so he's afraid of leaving, you know, that realm, you know. So that happens a lot. That's a big thing in the West. So there's many reasons, but they are anything but the real reason to be in a relationship. Right. The real why. I can talk about that, but there's much more profound reasons why we have relationships.
Such as?
Well, that's a good question.
Yeah.
That's a whole chapter. So what I, you know, this is one of the big questions I talk to guys about is why, you know. Why are we in relationship? Why do we seek relationship, right? And it's a deep question. It's a deep question. It's a deep answer. And have you ever heard of the limbic brain?
Yeah, the animal brain.
Yeah.
The reptilian brain.
Well, actually, the mammals have this limbic system.
Yeah.
That's actually one of the key factors of being a mammal. Mm-hmm. Mammals complete each other's nervous systems. And this is, now just think of what I said, we complete each other. We are not autonomous, enclosed.
We're not an amoeba.
We're not a closed circuit. We're not a nervous system that completely self-regulates.
Right.
We actually need other mammals to help regulate our nervous system. Mm-hmm. And you might remember me saying in the talk the other night that if you take a child away from its mother, at a young age, or when it's born, and you can feed the child, you can clothe the child, you can protect the child from harm, whatever. But if you don't communicate with that child, if you don't look at that child, if you don't touch the child, if you don't hold, you know, if you don't do those things that mothers do to their children.
Right, that nurturing.
That nurturing, the child dies. Even though you're feeding it and giving it food and shelter, if you don't give it the touch, the nervous system, that relationships, the nervous system that is at work in that relationship, that the child dies, dead.
Wow.
And they did many experiments with this when they did very arcane experiments in the past. It dies. It's like, it's not just it becomes depressed, you know, it freaking dies, you know. So it just dies. The nervous system doesn't actually develop properly. It doesn't evolve to the degree where it can self-sustain itself.
The relationship in itself gives that vitality.
The relational field itself allows that person to evolve. Like, it's fundamental substrata of its system.
Yeah.
You know. Now, in relationships, you know, we often men still have that same sort of need to have their nervous system conditioned by the feminine. Mm-hmm. Now, when a man is initiated, he's not so reliant on, it's not such a one-way street anymore. He's not relying on mother anymore.
Right.
But he's with a woman who's hopefully is also initiated. And so you have two people that are evolved beings mm-hmm. in relationship. They still complete their nervous system. They still have this limbic system at work
right.
where they're completing their nervous system's complete.
Yes, yes. Makes sense.
So they're helping each other to evolve. So they've got to a certain level of evolution, but then they have this deep connected relationship which actually accelerates that evolution to a greater field, right? So let me ask you, like, do you remember, can you think of the most substantial relationships in your life, right?
Yes.
Did you exit that relationship the same way you went into that relationship?
No, I grew.
You grew, yeah? Yeah. You either got smashed or you actually evolved, right?
The first time we got that sort of really, I think, I guess every man's graduation is to get their heart broken.
Right, yeah, that's definitely an initiation.
You graduated. Now you're a man.
Yeah, now you're a man. Now if you don't get over it, then you can keep repeating that for many lifetimes. But eventually you go, you know what, there's something more to it.
Yeah.
And it's very true. Like that relationship, but even the quality relationship, that really quality relationship you've had, if you can come through that relationship with integrity and come out of it with some sort of integrity, you can look back and know that you've actually evolved. Your acceleration has been very, your evolution has been really accelerated.
It's a positive liberation.
Yeah, it's an acceleration at some level, yeah. Your mind has been opened. Your whole nervous system has been opened.
Right.
You're able to take on much more of life
right.
through what you've dealt with and that, gone through in that relationship, yeah. So as far, you know, as much as it's great to have great sex and great times together and create things together and a family or whatever it is, or business, whatever, fundamentally what you're doing is helping each other to evolve.
Yeah.
That's the real why we are in a relationship.
The real purpose of a relationship.
Yeah.
Right.
And sexual relationships amplify that that evolution.
Yeah.
So it's like, the limbic system happens between us and everyone around us. Like, we're affecting each other.
Well, what do you animals really do for pleasure? When they're out to kick
yeah.
out and now
they're just what do you do, right?
You know,
so
it's been a whole weekend.
I know, you know, we can be on our own. We can just, you know, like, retreat into our own state mm-hmm. for years and years and be afraid of relating to people
yeah.
or women. But you don't evolve, you actually devolve. There's at some point where you sort of just like, sort of close in. And I see this a lot, you know. But when we really open our heart, when we really jump into the deep water of a relationship, you know, and even though it's deep and it's cold and it's freaky and it's, you know, like, if we can jump in and learn to swim, then we become like more connected human beings, you know. So yeah, so guys need to know that there's deeper reasons beyond just the comforts of relationship, mm-hmm. you know, beyond just getting a woman off, you know, beyond just getting off, beyond just having a hot chick on your arm, you know what I mean? This is all cool stuff,
mm-hmm.
but there's much more profound reasons why we are with women. And when we start to appreciate them, we have some context in which to start to want to become more masterful in the bedroom. We want to become more sensitive, more present, more creative in the sexual act itself, you know. Does that make sense?
It makes sense. It makes
pretty
sense.
I know it's a bit deep, you know. I go in pretty deep, so I'm sorry if I'm rushing in, but like, this is part of my work, you know.
Well, it's again finding that expression with the opposite sex or the partner you find, and I find for me personally it's learning to hone in a part of myself that I don't see in myself.
Right.
There's an interaction that
yeah.
I'm attracted to this person, besides just the physical, whatever it is.
Yeah,
there's something
yeah.
in her that I feel like I don't really possess.
Right.
So you know, and then it's that kind of like
right.
that joining forces there. So
right.
she's giving me something, obviously I'm giving her something, but it's not like a direct feedback.
Right.
You know.
It's sort of under the layer. It's,
yeah,
it's subconscious.
Right.
You're giving each other something that you don't quite know what it is, but you're really waking something up in each other, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Well, this is the thing. This is the other question I ask guys, right? It's like, not only why are you with a woman or with women, but who are you? Mm-hmm. Who are you? It goes right back to that identity. And if a guy is running around and he's unaware of what drives him, if he's unaware of the old schisms, the old fears and mm-hmm. Obsessions that drive him, if he isn't able to step back and feel his totality,
right.
That's a big word too, but if he isn't able to step back and feel his essence without running around trying to resolve this and this and this issue, if he isn't able to step back and feel his true essence, he's continually looking for himself in the other person.
Instead of owning it.
Instead of owning who he is in totality. Yeah? And what happens then is often we get in relationships where there's these unwritten contracts. So if you play out this scene for me, I will play out this scene for you. If you play this character for me, I will play this character for you.
Sure.
And it's all very subconscious. And so they form this really strong relationship based on their identities until one day they go, hey, who the hell is this person? Who am I? I haven't had spent any time inquiring into what our true nature, in what his or her true nature is, and trying to relate from that authentic place, you know? And that's a trick in itself. Getting the guys to come back to me.
So, guys, like as an example, a guy who gives all his attention and his focus to a woman,
right? Yeah.
Right, and that is his basically. That's where he operates. That's where he prioritizes. That's where he thinks. It's just basically let me please this woman, no matter what, and
yeah.
Then everything else comes second.
You're right.
You know. How does that, in terms of like who is he? Who is
yeah,
he?
Yeah.
I have a few friends, I'm trying to...
Man, that was me for many years, man, let me tell you. I was, you know, let me tell you from my own perspective, you know, through knowing, you know, like I definitely was a guy who, when I started learning this whole path of conscious sexuality around, you know, getting to Tantra, getting to Taoist sexual cultivation, getting into all these Eastern practices, getting into Western mysticism. You know, I went into these very, you know, reading all the books around sex and trying this technique and that technique. You know, it took me many years to realize that the very thing that was driving me to want to learn those things was based on a really low sense of self,
mm-hmm.
based on a sense of very low self-opinion, like on a deep level, you know.
Right.
It wasn't like I walked around as a depressed person. I was a generally functional, happy sort of guy. But underneath, I had this sense of like, you know, I really have to prove myself. I really have to prove that I'm the man. And I have to know these techniques in order to win. And if I can win women's approval and let them, and they would just be like, ah, you're the man. You know, like, I'd be like, yeah, you know, I'd put another notch on my belt and I'd be like,
it's the whole thing.
Fulfill
behind
me,
behind every successful man, there's an amazed woman.
There's an amazed woman. that's a good one. I haven't heard that one. Can I use that? Can I use that? It's good. Like, there's an amazed woman. Like, how did he do that? So, but it took me a while to realize that the very thing that was driving me to want to know all this stuff was actually my hindrance.
Okay.
Because while I became good at all these things, and while the women in my life were being very satisfied,
mm-hmm.
where the hell was I in all this? Where was I in all this? Was I satisfied? No, I wasn't actually satisfied.
Mm-hmm.
I had no idea what my needs were, right. My real needs were. Like, and a lot of women and culture itself and society says, oh, men have these very simple needs, you know. Men just want to eat food and have sex, you know,
yeah.
Like as long as they get...
And zone out at night.
Yeah, as long as they can just fill their face, you know...
Shed their load.
Blow their load, to be really crass, you know, sit down and watch TV, that's a man's needs.
Mm-hmm.
Well, screw that, man. I have much bigger needs than that. I'm sorry. And if a guy thinks that's what his sole purpose to be on this planet is to do, just to eat, to screw and to watch and just to zone out on the TV, then take, beam me up, Scotty. You know, like, I don't want to be here.
He's missing out on the alchemy.
He's missing out on life itself, actually. Right. He's missing out on the mystery and beauty of life. And that sounds a bit lofty, but really, there is. We are not here just to do those things. I mean, if every guy sat down and really got real with himself, he'd realize that there's much more potency within him. There's much deeper reasons for him being on this planet than just to sort of nullify his base instincts. Yeah, there's deeper reasons, and so when I started to wake up and go, you know what am I here to do? Why aren't I feeling met in relationships? Why am I giving everything out and getting nothing back? Well, because I don't know myself. I wasn't ready to open myself up and go, hey, who am I? And let a woman start revealing to me who I am, or start to access that part of me, right. You know.
That's your inner world.
My inner world. So yeah, so when I start to reveal that inner world, and she starts going, oh, wow, that's who you are. Mm-hmm. Fearlessly, then, funny enough, I started to get much more satisfied sexually.
Okay.
On the basic level, sex became much better. Mm-hmm. My relationships with the world around me became much better. Yeah. You know, I became a bit more less distracted and less.
And so yeah, focus on.
Yeah, I wasn't so focused on this performance achievement. I started to be a human being, mm-hmm. rather than a human doing.
Right.
You know, which is a very common saying now. Like, are you a human being or are you a human doing? And most men in the bedroom are human doings. They're always doing something.
They're doing stuff to the girl.
Yeah, like you said, like your friend, you know, he's always doing something to try and impress her. But is the guy actually being? Is the guy's essential nature being revealed?
And that's a disservice to her, really.
Exactly. She's probably lying, you know, she's probably lying there going, what the hell are you doing? This happens a lot. You know, a guy learns a few techniques, sexual techniques and tricks. And he goes, "Ooh, I've got some cool stuff. I read in, you know, HQ magazine or like, you know, men's, what is that magazine?
Like GQ.
Men's FHM, Health, GQ, you know, like, great magazines, but man, some of the articles on sexuality is just like,
kind of weak.
What? That's weak. Yeah, let's be real. Men are taking a few techniques to go and do them, and then the woman's just going, where are you and who are you?
It's not an experiment.
Yeah, I'm not your guinea pig here. Like, where are you?
Press a few buttons.
Yeah, right? Women know this. And they'll either, like I said, they'll either indulge you, like, yeah, go for it. Or they'll just say, hey, dude, where are you? Or they'll shut down themselves, mm-hmm. you know,
yeah.
and become just a love doll.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's actually, there's a lot going on here. So yeah, I ask the guys, who are you? Why are you in relationship? Who are you? And then I ask them, where are you? Like, where are you? Like, when you're making love with them, where are you? You know, are you here? Are you present?
Yeah.
It comes back to the.
What are you just thinking about some other girl?
Yeah, are you off thinking about some technique? Yeah. You know, some other girl, like.
Or you thinking about your performance?
How you're performing? Yeah. Exactly. It's where.
You're in the zone.
Yeah. You're not in the zone, man. You're not in that beautiful zone, you know.